Welcome back, everybody. Max here with Cattle Hunting, and today it is Junk Silver time. Look at this beautiful bag of Junk Silver. As you guys know, I like to go to my Junk Scrap Silver dealer on Saturdays here in the flea market, and I am super, super happy what I picked up today. I increased my budget a little bit after seeing silver surging a little bit the last few days before the market closed yesterday. So all the pointers point to silver going up a little bit more next week, so I thought that I would rather spend my next week's budget this week and also turn in some of my scrap jewelry that I still had lying around and get some nice silver coins, because my junk silver dealer warned me last week that he's gonna bring me like a whole bag of coins to go through that he wants to scrap, so I was prepared that I buy a little bit more. In the end, I bought $410 worth of junk silver. I haven't gone through everything yet completely and sorted it out. I know what I got here because I picked it out, so it's all kind of better things, and some Canadian, some older Canadian, some European coins. There's some 90% US junk silver in there. There's a couple of pieces of bullion in there too, some sterling coins. It's a good mix. I will pour it out for you guys, that you guys get a good feeling and you get this nice sound. Beautiful pile of junk silver here. Exactly the stuff I love. Many, many beautiful coins, and I can't wait to sort it out, do the math, tell you guys how much I paid and all of this stuff. So let me go ahead, sort it out and present it for you guys nicely, and then we can talk about it coin by coin, and I hope you enjoy it. Alright guys, we have it all sorted out here. Beautiful silver coins. I'm super, super happy with today's purchase, with all kinds of different cool coins, and it's really, really fun to go through it and do the math and like just check out all the coins you got. So overall we paid $410 Canadian for this today, and this is the silver price on it is roughly $430, so we are somewhere around 5% under spot price here, which brings us to somewhere close to $2550, which is super, super awesome. To get coins under spot is always amazing. This is a tiny little bit under spot, and that's exactly the sweet spot where I want to buy my silver coins. And what I pay most of the time is around spot to minus 10% of spot. And that is perfectly awesome and perfectly fair, because the scrap metal dealers, they basically would sell it for the to the refinery for like 10% under, so 5% under is very, very often what they accept. So I'm super happy with that. Let's see what we have here. We have a bunch of Canadian stuff, we have a bunch of American stuff, and then we have a random assortment of kind of European stuff and some Indian and South American coins, so it's really, really cool. We have three Canadian half dollars here. We have a 1953, which is a slightly better date, only like 1.7 million made. And we have two 1958s. So I like picking up some of the 50s half dollars because I don't really have so many. I focused a lot on the George heads, so I saw those three on the 50s and I took them today. I really liked them. We have here the 1937 Canadian dollar, which I'm super, super, super happy with. It's actually in quite decent condition. It's a bit tarnished, but the luster on it is very, very good. It has not many, many scratches and not much use. And you don't see those ones very, very often. It's the only $1 coin in this design with King George V on them. And it's a beautiful, heavy, nice 80% silver coin. And I'm super, super happy that that was included in this deal, because I really, really like this coin. We have three Canadian quarters here. We have this 1960 that I took because it's in very nice condition. And then we have two 1930s, 138 and 137 George head. We have four more King George V quarters here. Only one is sterling. This one here is a 1919 sterling. They stopped making sterling silver coins in 1920 in Canada, so everything pre-1920 is 30. And those three here are all 80%ers. I think two of them are dateless. Let me check this out. This one is a 1929, and the other two, I can't really see the date. Maybe I will find it under the microscope when I check those coins later, but for now I didn't see it. We have a bunch of Canadian dimes here. We have six sterling silver King George V dimes here. Actually, there's maybe a couple of King Edward VI on there too, but all of these are sterling, and the same here, everything after 1919 is actually 80%, so 580% King George V over here. And then we have a bunch around 15 or 20 King George VI here. We have a few in the 30s, but nothing special. And then one lonely Canadian sterling silver 5-cent piece over here, with damage in the middle from some kind of jewelry or pendant or whatever somebody put it on. We have a total of 5 US Walking Liberty half dollars here. This one is a 1940. We have a 1943 here. We have 3 1945s. So I always love picking up US coinage. US 90% coinage is one of my favorite coinage to stack, and I always take all the Walking Liberties I can get my hands on for a decent price. Same as the Franklin half dollars. We have 2 over here. This one is a 1953. Love the design on those ones. And this one is a 1963. Absolutely beautiful. We have 3 US quarters here, all Washington quarters 90%. We have a 61, we have a 64, and we have a 53. Again, nothing special here. And then we have a total of 10 US dimes. That is 5 Mercury dimes and 5 Roosevelt dimes. So overall, just a good standard Canadian and US junk silver bunch with maybe a little bit better selection than usual. Especially the $36 here is something I really, really, really enjoy because I didn't really find many of those before. Let's continue down here. We have this one here. It's actually the second one of those for me. This one is a 1967 Canadian Confederate medallion, and they are sterling silver, 25 grams. So it's a chunky silver medallion, actually not a coin, but super happy that I found the second one of those. I'm a big fan of heavy sterling silver coins. It's something I always want to pick up, and I'd like to have some variety. And then over here we have a bunch of Austrian coins, actually 4 of them. Austrian coins are a bit difficult because the percentages vary quite a lot. So we have this 100 shilling 1976 here, which is 50% silver, I believe. And we have 2 50 shilling pieces here that are actually 90%ers. One is an Olympic coin and the other one is a Confederation coin or something like that. And we have a 25 shilling here that is actually 80% silver. But I love those coins. They're super nice and chunky. Beautiful design. And we have a few British 50%ers as well. We have a half crown, a shilling, and 3 sixpences. All 50% silver, nothing special. But always happy to pick up a few of those if I can. Very, very nice design. And I love the European coins. Then we have this beautiful shiny proof coin over here. It's from the Olympic Games in Sarajevo, 1984. Only 100,000 minted sterling silver. This kind of stuff is awesome when I find it in junk silver bags. I'm very, very, very happy to pick this up. It's a beautiful coin and I'm very glad to have it. And down here we have some more European stuff and some exotic stuff. We have a 1 gulden 1954, 72% silver. We have a 10 cents straight settlements. I think it's 1918 with King George V on the back here. This one is actually cool. This is a Dominican Republic 1963 10 centavos. Love this coin. Beautiful design. Then we have 2 Dutch colonial coins here. This one is a 10th of a gulden East Indies. This one is very, very pretty on the reverse. Very nice. And we also have a 10th of a gulden from Curaçao, 1947. Beautiful small coin. 72% silver, like the Dutch coins usually are. We have a Victorian, actually, 3 pence here. 1889. Queen Victoria on the back. This one unfortunately also wasn't a piece of jewelry or something. It has been broken out of there pretty roughly, so it's definitely not in the good, best shape, but it's still a nice small sterling silver coin that I love to pick up for junk silver price. We have a South African 80% 3 pence here in 1946. And then we have 2 really cool small exotic coins here. This one is Ceylon, so Sri Lanka 1903. With King Edward VI on there, and this one is really, really nice. 10 cents, nice little small sterling silver coin. And over here we have the oldest coin of the day. This is actually a 4 pence, it's actually slightly bigger than the 3 pence pieces. If you see, it's very interesting. I like to see those kind of weird coins, weird denominations. This one is an 1840 Victoria with the Victoria head on the back and the sitting Britannia on the other side. It's a sterling silver coin. Absolutely beautiful. Love to get those. Then we actually have some bullion over here, and this was definitely one of my favorite pickups here. These ones are 5 gram silver bullion CMC mint silver bars. So they're 5 grams pure silver. Absolutely awesome to get those for spot price, because bullion is so hard to find for anything but crazy premiums right now. But these ones are beautiful. They have a nice beautiful mousse on there, and I'm very, very happy to own those. And then the last thing I bought was actually funny, because they also have this kind of junk jewelry piles, and I saw this in the junk jewelry pile. I have to show you guys. So this is a broken bracelet, and this is all 2 Anna pieces. So this is really collectible coins. Those 2 Anna Victorian sterling coins are actually very, very popular. Unfortunately, they have those hinges on there, but they seem to be, it seems to be possible to remove them to make the coin look at least decent. And I love the Indian coins, so I definitely took this, because I only paid $7 for this. I'm very, very sure, even in very bad condition, you don't find any of those coins for under $10. So I'm super, super happy to get 4 of them for 7, even though they are obviously heavily damaged by being trapped in a piece of jewelry. It's very, very unfortunate, but I still love those coins very, very much, so I had to take them. Overall, I got a really nice variety over here. There was a huge selection this time, but again, as most of the time, almost the majority of the stuff is just very common Canadian young head junk silver coins. That's the majority of it, and there's a lot of that. I didn't really want to pick up more Canadian half dollars and dollars today, because all the dollars were the very common, like 63, 64, 65, 66. And there was no George heads, or not even any a little bit in the 50s. So I only took this one Canadian dollar, and the same for the half dollars. I picked most of the better dates and the better looking coins there already recently, so there was not really much in that department. So I focused on trying to get more of the foreign stuff and the nice US silver and older Canadian stuff that I could pick out of this, out of there. And overall, I really like the result. Getting this kind of stuff under spot is always very, very, very awesome. And I am very, very happy with it. Let me guys know what your 5 favorite coins are in the slot. For me, it's probably the $36. I really like the Yugoslavian Olympic coin as well. And the 2 silver bullion bars. That's all very, very nice coins. But everything overall is absolutely beautiful. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Let me know if you want to see more videos like this, and what kind of coins you love, and which coins in this lot are your favorites. I see you guys next time, and have a good one.